The power that Allah has given to us is something that people don't understand. In reality, we have ability to manifest. People don't understand the heavenly, but look what they're doing with the satanic. So with social media, all of this alter ego is now manifesting. If you can manifest every type of negativity and every type of horrific thing, then imagine the power of positive manifestation. Allah inspired within our hearts that leave that which shaitan worships and what he desires of his kingdom and run towards the kingdom of Divinely Presence, the heart of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. And that in that heart is the secret of manifestation. Prophet ﷺ teaching for us that everybody will have a companion in the grave. And Sahabi asked that, "What is that companion?" And said, "Your deeds. If your deeds are good, that companion will be a good companion that will support you through every difficulty and every trial and tribulation within the grave. And if your deeds are bad, your companion will be a source of immense difficulty and torment." Means that actions of people manifest, and they manifest in the grave. And because we are the people of Malakut, the grave and living life is the same for us, that the manifestation is visible. For those whom hearts are open, they don't need to wait to death to see that being that in front of them. Even the crazy people, they understood and they accept, and they go and teach everybody that, "Oh, your bad deeds, they're going to manifest in the grave and punish you and punish you and punish you." But yet they forget to remind people that the negativeness within somebody, if you give it a life and you give it power, it will manifest. Because we don't understand the nafs and we don't understand how demonic it can become. The power that Allah has given to us is something that people don't understand. وَلَقَدْ كَرَمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ. He gave us the ability to think, but in reality we have ability to manifest. This is a very powerful power that Allah gave to us. People don't understand the heavenly, but look what they're doing with the satanic. Shaitan is using their power to manifest. Everyone's manifesting their alter ego that was bad. Everybody had these bizarre desires, nobody knew about them. So with social media, all of this alter ego is now manifesting. Now the whole world is posting lives they don't have, cars they don't have, money they don't have, bodies they don't have, faces that are not even their faces. So when they use their God-given gift to think of these horrible things, Allah's allowing them to conjure it and manifest it. And as a result, it takes on an existence. Imagine all the negativity with that creature that you just brought into this world and gave it an image, and now it's taking on a force of their own. That's the demon that's now appearing. That entity and that nafs is now very powerful, very demonic, very dunya oriented, and it begins to influence their actual own personality. And that will now come back to destroy the physicality. And that's why then the tariqahs come to teach that you are a very powerful being, manifested in Allah's way.
As-salamu alaykum. We hope that you're enjoying the video, inshallah. Just a request that you help us continue to make such amazing Islamic content, inshallah. Share this video with your friends and loved ones, subscribe to the channels, and donate. Every bit helps. Jazakallah khair, and we will return to the program.
There are many different people coming in new for the first time. They click one day and they're listening. We haven't heard these examples of manifestation, we haven't, nobody's ever talked about that. I don't think there's anyone you click anywhere where they understood the reality of manifesting. Because this was from Iqra, Qalam bin Qalam. That Allah will make everything to begin to manifest by your reality. That every knowledge of this insan will begin to manifest. And Allah gave immense power in their hands, an immense reality within their finger and their thumb, and that their ability to hold the qalam, the power of that qalam opened upon this earth the ability of all manifestation. Every building you see around us now is because of manifestation. Allah didn't build it. Allah inspired you to build it, and it wasn't here. 200, 300, 500 years ago, nothing was here. So as everything is manifesting, the most powerful manifestation are those that which manifest for Allah. That what power the servant has, that when he reads Qur'an, when he reads salawat and nabi, what happens in the process of making du'a? What type of manifestation from the oceans of energy, a door for them begins to open, and the attribute takes an existence. It keeps directing towards your heart to keep the compass of your heart correct, so that their internal eye and their internal heart is always directed towards Allah and the love of Sayyidina Muhammad. This becomes our companion in life. This becomes a reality of our existence and the reality of guidance. All the du'as that they ask of us to recite and all of the awrads and etiquettes that they're giving to us are manifesting for us. If we could see, it would be like a fountain in front of us. And then that du'a is continuously providing for us, that dress the heart, dress the heart, dress my vision, keep my heart and my vision to be firm. And that's what we said, Nazar bar qadam, that in our lives the nazar and the path are related, and the nazar has to do with what's in my heart. What's in my heart is guiding my path, and what's in my heart will control my eyes. So that which my eyes are trying to attain in life, it will affect my heart. So then all these du'as, they are strong manifestations of protection, and they begin to manifest for us as a continuous guidance and support upon our path. And that's the power that Allah has given to us. It has an eternal reality, and because we don't understand it, all they want us to know is the reality of manifestation. If the one whom all day long is drawing horrific creatures and demonic things, and the other one whom sitting and reading Qur'an and making salawat and doing durood shareef, just what do you think they're manifesting? What type of negativity one creature is manifesting, and what type of heavenly realities another creature is manifesting?
A Timeless Reality with Shaykh Nurjan Mirahmidi guides the reader in meditation, connecting the heart to a guide and to daily spiritual practices to understand the effects of positive and negative energy, and to progress the reader in their spiritual awakening and the soul's connection to the world of light. The Divine's Ancient Timeless Reality. Order on Amazon.com. With your generous support, we have helped many of the needy around the world. You can make a difference right now by helping us support those who need it the most. Give now at nurmuhammad.com/donate.
What happens in the process of making salawat upon Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? That's why the schools of adab, they teach you manners, right? Because one salawat upon the reality of Sayyidina Muhammad Prophet described that, my soul will come to be present with you. Right there is now a manifestation. That's why the reality of guidance is Allah go sit with these people from the world of light, so they can astonish you with what Allah has given to insan. And as a result, those whom are reciting and sincere, because sincere servants, that they make salawat with sincerity, those salawats are immensely powerful. That they continuously have the presence of the light of Sayyidina Muhammad with them, accompanying them. There are people who say, there's no difference between people. One whom is praising and praising and praising and making du'a, many realities are manifesting in front of them, and as a result of those manifestations, they dress the servant, they bless the servant, they give the guidance to the servant. So the servant is not left as something empty that they left alone for shaitan to attack. So just by the understanding of that, we can understand that there are enormous differences in people. The one whom reaches sincerity, every action that they do, Allah grants it its reality. That world of light manifests and opens for them, and that's what was trying to be conveyed today. that there is a being that Allah that will make an angelic reality of you. And there are many hadiths that describe, I saw a beautiful face and this face came to me, and Prophet described it, what is this face? Says, I'm the face of your good amal, and every beatific thing and every good thing that you have done, that I'll be dressing you from its reality. Means it comes in a shape and a form of something beatific. And that's what we were trying to be conveyed tonight, is that when we do the awrad, do the zikr and do the practices, Allah is making a very beatific angelic reality that's present in front of you. And that's why when you're sincere and you're doing your actions, doing the recitations, doing all these practices, these are not performances and this is not a show. Every nasheed that you recite, every du'a that you recite, every awrad that been recited, every practice and zikr that we're doing, you are bringing and manifesting a very beatific and powerful angel that has an appearance more beatific than yourself, no matter how beautiful you think you are. This one is of an immense light reality and it sits right in front of you and keeps sending every prayer that you're making. That reality is actually praying for you, those prayers, dressing you, blessing you, asking to take away all those difficulties. So as if you are reciting, you are giving it its reality, you are bringing that reality to life, and that's what Allah wants. That make that companion of yours powerful, make that companion of yours to be immensely powerful by recitation of Qur'an, by recitation of Salatul Nabi ﷺ, by awrads and zikrs and du'as. All of these practices, you need that one to be powerful. And in these times of difficulty and these times of shaitan attacking, he's the one that will be helping you. He's the one whom is pure from Allah's Divinely Presence. And begins to pray for you, begin to pray for you, begin to intercede for you, and shaitan is trying to make you sick through all of this azab on this earth. It's your amal that come and begin to make an intercession for you, intercede for you, take away difficulty from you. So Prophet in the section of the amal and the tribulations of death, how all our deeds are manifesting. But for people whom their life is from malakut and they want from the world of life, that person that Allah describing, they are seeing it. And that reality is dressing them and blessing them. We pray that Allah inspire us to do good deeds and to recite the du'as, recite the awrads, recite the salawats, do the salawat al Nabi ﷺ, dalal khairat, Qur'an, all of these, so that creation, that reality becomes strong and blessed and filled with light. Allah opens that light within the heart of the servant so that their Muhammadan light, the Muhammadan kingdom begin to open within their heart. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. That du'a is for Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. And as a result, that light opens in the heart of the servant, blesses the servant, begins to guide the servant, begins to guide them towards every goodness that Allah wants, and refraining from every badness that Allah asks us to abstain from. We pray that Allah dress us and bless us with the immensity of the love of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ, and only by means of that love is our najat. Because when the servant has that love and everything they do wrong and every shortcoming they have, they know only love can save them. That when we have this love for Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ, and the expression and the proof of that love, the proof is in your actions that make that love to shine, that make that love to show. So when they see you, they say, oh, you guys are Muhammadan. Yes, you're very right, you're Muhammadan. That you have an immense love and that everything about you is carrying that flag and that muhabbat and that ishq and that love. So this power of manifestation, just think that what's manifesting with the tariqah, battalions of armies that are preparing upon earth for the arrival of what Dajjal is planning. Allah's not leaving this to be an empty game. So these are the realities that are manifesting. Every du'a that been recited, every app that you download and begin to recite, when you recite the madad in your house, what's happening? What type of lights are coming into the home? How could we feel that we have a shortcoming when He gave everything but we don't even know what we have? And that's why they teach, and that's why they propagate, and that's why they're trying their best to spread the good word, inshaAllah. We pray that Allah increase us in that love, and that Kingdom's light to emanate from our hearts, and that love to save us, our family, our community, and all those whom come in touch with us, inshaAllah. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifoon, wa salaamun al mursaleen, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Bi hurmati Muhammad al Mustafa wa bi siri Surat al Fatiha.
If money could just grow on trees, there would be no need for this message. Since it doesn't, let us show you where your generous donations are going. We film, edit, and produce weekly television shows of Divinely Knowledge throughout Canada and the UK, as well as live stream internationally on Facebook and YouTube. Sheikh Nurjan's ever-growing online presence is the result of continuous financial input, and with your financial assistance and participation, this rapid growth will continue. Our Muhammadan Way app is continuously being upgraded and improved, providing an all-encompassing Islamic guide. In addition to the Muhammadan Way app, nurmuhammad.com is a website of immense knowledge and comprehensive Islamic teachings that is updated daily. Your ongoing support also enables a team of editors to compile books of heavenly wisdom from Sheikh Nurjan's teachings. One of our longest ongoing initiatives has been to provide basic necessities to the most in need worldwide, from feeding people in Vancouver's downtown east side, to clothing LA's homeless community, and supporting a children's orphanage in Pakistan. Your ongoing donations will help us continue to spread the love and example of the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. Become a shareholder in immense blessings. nurmuhammad.com/donate.